what kind of activities we will have to expose our children to. Now there is a rush to teach children various activities, put them in structured classes, say put them in drawing class, in art class, or in painting class, or in early chess, the beginner's chess, or skating classes, tennis classes, dancing classes, music classes, etc. So what are we doing when we are putting them into classes? See, already they are getting exposed to formal structured learning in the process of play school, preschool and school. In addition to that, when we are introducing them to various classes, once again we are giving them the concept of having an instructor who expects the children to follow certain rules and regulations and fall into place in a systematic manner. When a parent is involving a child in classes to an extent that a child goes from one class to another class from 4 o'clock to evening 7 p.m. what happens? The child is robbed of the unstructured time that they can develop their own ideas about. So what happens in a structured environment? They have to follow certain rules, and once again there is going to be comparison, and there is going to be a target for achievement, and also there is going to be an expectation from the parents who is paying money to get the skill imbibed into the child. So what kind of activities are suitable for this age? It is essential that the child has to play in open air. So all indoor games come to a standstill. Let us not do it. Between 4 and 7 in the evening, the child has to play in open air, because that is the time there will have some sun exposure. And also when there is an unstructured time, the child learns to boss over one day and take over the leadership quality, and the next day they would not be the leader because someone else assumes the leadership role and they will have to follow rules, so that they know how a team is formed and how they can relax the team rules depending on the concerned leader, and they can also form groups among themselves and form a teamwork and proceed as a play group. But in the absence of that, what happens? The child will always expect an adult to conduct the group. In the absence of an adult, they do not know how to mingle among themselves, and they are losing a very, very important social skill. Let us put them into group activities where they can play, say for example, coco, or they can learn how to do a catching game, or we can have the human chain formation. Such kind of games will make them, or even hide and seek for that matter, will help the child in a larger way.